Hello, I'm Elliot. So you're thinking about adding 3D printing to your school. That's a good idea, since 3D printing opens up a new world for both students and teachers. You may be asking yourself, how can I manage my school's 3D printers? What about managing who can access them, their basic maintenance and printing costs? YSoft B3D eDee is a 3D printer with a comprehensive set of software tools that make managing your 3D print fleet easy. When your 3D printers arrive, your service provider will install the printers, set up the print management software, and do everything needed to be fully operational. But like me, you probably want to know how it all works. So this is what we'll cover today. We'll look at the main parts of the eDee 3D printer, including the locking doors and how the filament spool is loaded. We'll look at all the functions and settings of the printer available only to administrators. Finally, we will walk through the features and settings available to you in the YSoft SafeQ print management software, including how the pay for print feature works if you opt to use it. So, let's get started. The eDee printer fits well on a desktop table. The main door locks during printing to keep students and faculty safe from heat and moving parts, and to also ensure the model is collected only by its rightful owner. If your school uses ID badges, you may want to order your eDee printer with the RFID card reader that sits inside the printer. You and students can simply swipe your badge to get access. Otherwise, you can assign usernames and passwords. The filament spool chamber door is on the side and is only unlocked by an administrator. This is where you will insert new spools when you are notified that the spool needs to be replaced. Operating the printer is done through a pull-out touchscreen. Students will use the screen to start and finish their 3D printing, and you will use it to change printer settings. Periodically, the 3D printer's nozzle will need to be replaced. This is what the nozzle looks like. Just like maintenance is needed on 2D printers, for 3D printers, it's the nozzle that should be replaced after about 1400 hours of use. I'll show you how to reset the counter. The back of the printer has the power button, power, and LAN slots. eDee printers are network printers, and that's an important point because students need to be able to print from any available printer. When they submit their print job, it waits on a server until they get to an eDee printer and requests the job to print. Those are the main areas of the 3D printer. Now, let's explore what you can do on a 3D printer through the touchscreen interface. Now let's look at the printer settings and configurations that only the administrator can access. To access the admin login screen, tap the two lower right and left corners for a total of four taps. Enter your password and the service menu will appear. It is from the service menu that most of your administrator tasks on the printer will be done. Since your service provider will have set your printers and software up for you, we will not spend time on the network, card reader, or access menus. But if you ever need to change your network settings, ID cards, or an administrator password, these menu areas are where you would configure those settings. Let's start with filament manipulation. When you want to change a filament color or replenish an empty spool, this is where you start. In order to remove any filament in the channel, the nozzle needs to heat up to make it easier to remove the filament. Once the indicator says the nozzle is ready, select Remove Filament. Once removed, tap on the red X to indicate that the filament is removed, and then select Feed Filament In. Insert the loose end of the filament into the silicon tube in the spool chamber until it reaches the printhead. You'll feel a slight resistance, and with slight pressure, push it through. Once the filament has been fed through, select the red X to indicate the filament is in. Then, set the color of the new filament. If there was a job currently being printed when the filament ran out, you can resume the job. Another occasional maintenance is the nozzle head. The nozzle head needs replacing after about 1400 hours of use to prevent clogging. Your service manual provides step-by-step instructions, including how to adjust the nozzle offset once the nozzle is replaced. Once the nozzle is replaced, the counter needs to be reset for the next 1400 hours of use. Simply click the button to reset the counter. The print and manual control menu lets you manually manipulate the printer, including opening front and side doors, pause or terminate the job currently printing, print out diagnostic prints, or move the print bed and print head. The Notifications menu is where you can define who receives email notifications. There are two kinds of notifications, Job Owner and Administrator. Although the eDee system will inform the student how long his print job will take, receiving an email notification serves as a reminder to come and collect the 3D model so someone else can use the printer. For the administrator, being notified of a problem or when a filament needs to be replaced allows quick action to get the printer in use again. The administrator also receives notification when a refund is requested by a student when pay-to-print services are enabled. I'll show how this works later. The preference menu allows you to set the touchscreen display's brightness setting should you move the printer to a location with different lighting. You can also set the display's fade-out timeout to help conserve energy. Lastly, units can be displayed in metric or imperial, and the display can trigger a logout if no activity is detected in the defined time. This is useful when students or administrators forget to log out. So these are the 3D printer menus that administrators are likely to use in managing and maintenance of eDee 3D printers. Now let's show you the administrator part of YSoft SafeQ. SafeQ is the print management software that enables you to manage access to printers, reports, and if using pay for print, the payment services. Your service provider will have installed and set up YSoft SafeQ on your servers. Let's take a look at the dashboard. The dashboard provides an instant look at your 3D print system. You can add different widgets to your dashboard to create the view you want. For now, I want to show you how to manage 3D printer users, the reports, and how pay-to-print services work. Let's start with users. In order to manage who can access the printer, and to ensure that the printer doors open only to the rightful job owner, eDee requires users to enter their credentials. Your service provider will set this up for you, but as an administrator, you can add additional users or remove users. You can choose to do this in several ways. Import a CSV file, replicate from LDAP, or manual entry. You may choose to do this for the entire student population or for certain classes. As the users may change by each school term, importing or LDAP synchronization is handy, whereas manual entry can be used to add new students, for example. In this screen, you can see a list of users and can manually add, edit, or delete as needed. In a similar way, 3D printers can be added. Again, your service provider will likely do this for you, but should you need to make any changes, the Devices menu is where the printer configurations are set. To monitor usage and costs, you will want to review the reports that YSoft SafeQ offers. YSoft SafeQ comes with reports already set up. You can schedule reports to be automatically generated and emailed to you, or create your own reports by date range. Typical reports include number of jobs on all printers or specific printers. You may want to report on jobs printed by a particular user. The reports indicate the amount of filament used, how long each job took to print, and the cost, if cost information is configured. Speaking of costs, you may want to provide 3D printing as a pay-to-print service. In this way, students or faculty can create prepaid accounts, and eDee will check to see if their accounts have enough funds for the job before it prints. Let me show you how it works. As an administrator, I can manage student accounts, or this can be managed by an office administrator or faculty member. Whoever you choose to manage this has the YSoft Cash Desk application on their desktop. You can set up as many cash desks as needed. If you're maintaining actual currency, the adding and subtracting is similar to a real cash register, and at the end of the day, a reconciliation with the actual currency can be done. Within a cash desk, you can accept currency deposits and print deposit receipts. In the same way, withdrawals can be made. YSoft also offers an automated payment machine where students can enter currency or use a credit card through a payment gateway, such as PayPal and other popular payment systems to add to their account. It may happen that students need a refund if their print job did not turn out as expected due to unforeseen circumstances. At the eDee printer, the student is shown a print summary of their job, like this screen, and can request a refund. When Request Refund is selected, eDee takes a photo of the 3D model and emails it to the administrator. Then, The printer door unlocks and the student is advised to take the model to the administrator. The administrator receives an email alert with the photo attached, along with details about the job owner, the printer, and the job itself. The administrator, or office staff member, can proceed to refund the student's account through the cash desk application. So, now we've covered the basic administrative tasks of managing your fleet of eDee printers. One more thing. We've talked about how YSoft SafeQueue is the print management software inside of the eDee solution. But did you know that the same YSoft SafeQueue license can be used to manage your 2D paper printers? With print management on 2D printers, you can manage your printing costs, create automated scan workflows, and you'll have the tools necessary to eliminate print waste and optimize your paper printer fleet. Ask your 3D print provider or contact YSoft. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed learning about YSoft B3D eDee print management.